Okay, they say this unit here, which you can see it right right there around the corner, they say air conditioning works great. That's because I tore the thing apart and cleaned the heck out of it, and it's all working. Now they say they turn the heat on, and after it runs about 10 minutes, it trips a breaker. At least I know it's not the compressor. Shorten out because the air conditioner still works. So we're going to find out what's going on. Let's turn it on and see what we can figure out. I just love where they, hopefully this is just leaning here. Yeah, okay. Ready to say. Ooh, that's nice. Splinter in the finger. Nice. All right, it wants to rattle a little bit. The maximum fuse is 30 for the compressor and everything. Now the heat strips, depends on which one they have in there, but that's not the one they say it's tripping. It shuts the whole system down, so it has to be the one that runs the compressor. So, 30 max. Right now, you can see it's in heat mode, and it's running at 8.1. It's slowly, but climbing. They said it runs about 10 minutes, and then it trips. We're going to let it run and see what happens. It's got a good ways to go for it to trip a breaker. Go get the gauges and see if it's got a restriction in it and it's putting too much pressure on the compressor. That might be tripping it in heat mode if it's got a clog in it somewhere that it's not, even though the reversing valve is reversing, but if it's something that's stopped up, it'd build that head pressure and trip that breaker. Well, after I ran it in heat mode for 15 minutes, it never got above 11 amps on the line that they say that keeps breaking. Compressor is not pulling too many amps. The maximum is 30. It's got a number 10 wire. Now I did find one thing that might attribute it to it. This ground lug was so loose that I can just touch it with a finger and it would actually spin. So it did not have a good ground, so I tightened it up. And I tightened up the lugs here. I flipped it back and forth from heat and cool while it was running by the reversing valve to see if I can really get a strain on the compressor to get it to trip. It still never went above 11 point some amps. So I have no idea what it is. I've seen this happen before, and the only thing it was then was they had a breaker in an old house that was weak, that was tripping sooner than it should be. And if it goes in defrost, it will be pulling more amps because the fan's not running and the pressure gets higher, it will pull amps a little bit more. So if it creeps up enough and the breaker is too sensitive on the end of the house, which this is what they got on the outside, it's just disconnect pull out, so it's not able to do anything here. So if the breaker in the house is weak, there's a possibility that's going to be the issue. But I cannot get this to pull no more than roughly about a half of the amps that it's supposed to. Minimum circuit I do believe is like 21 point something. and it's running 11 something every time. Don't matter if it's in air condition, heat, switching back and forth, it don't even spike above 11 point something. So it's doing what it's supposed to do. I think it's probably going to end up with something to do with the breaker inside, or if there's a loose wire in here, it can build up heat, which they're not loose, all nice and tight up in the lug nuts, so that's not an issue. So breaker, that's the only thing I can think of. Well, I got it back together, and I still come up thinking that it's going to be the breaker just being too weak, tripping before it's supposed to. Pressure's not too high, amps are not even high enough to even trip the breaker. Don't matter if it's in heat, air condition, switching it back and forth as it runs into heat and cool, trying to get it to build up pressure, put a strain on the compressor. So I just tightened up all the wires that I found and the lug nuts and stuff that I thought that was loose that needed to be tightened. And that's all I can really do. If it keeps doing it, eventually that breaker is going to get to the point where it won't run at all. So then we'll know what it is.